All right, so let me do a demo for the AWS external key store. Firstly, go to the KM service in AWS. So you can see basically you have a choice of AWS managed keys, custom managed keys, and then external key store is the new item that I want to demonstrate together with CipherTrust manager. Right, so you can see in this Tokyo region, I have no external key stores. I will demonstrate how to use CipherTrust Manager to create a new one and then create the external keys, which is hold your own key and then encrypt the file with that particular key. Log into my CipherTrust Manager. You can see all the different modules as usual in terms of classification, encryption. But today our topic is on the CipherTrust Cloud Key Management. Within Cloud Key Management, actually we have all the major Cloud Key Management capability cover in terms of AWS, Azure, Google, and so on and so forth. But my topic today is about external key management with AWS. So with that, I would just work on the account I have earlier created, which is AWS Tokyo account. Right, so the account is basically just using your AWS access secret key. You can create a connection, and then based on the region, you can create an account. So in this, I have created the account just using the access key and itself. Right, within the account, you can have the choice of using the cloud HSM keys as well as the external customer key store, which is my demonstration today. So let me add the CCKM key store. The region for this account only linked to Tokyo region, so you can see only that option. And then in the key source, you have a choice of CipherTrust as well as Luna HSM. Right, so for today's simple demo, I'll just go through CipherTrust. Of course, if you want higher level security and certification, you can use Luna hardware security modules. That's also well supported. You have a choice to use a link or unlink. For demonstration purpose, I will choose the link. Of course, more options explanation is here in the Thales talk, all available. I will not go through too much explanation on the different choices. For this demo purpose, I will just use linked as well as the public access external key store, which is my means my key store is actually external accessible with using a public DNS. Of course, if you want to handle larger workload, which require more performance requirement in terms of latency, AWS VPC connection is recommended in those production usage cases. Right, so for today, I'm just give the public DNS name for my CipherTrust manager, and then I choose a key which I created earlier to do the health check, and you can choose actually the credentials. So that's all you need, and then create a key store. Right, so you can see it's a key store being successfully created, and actually it generates an access key and secret which you can download and then keep it for reference and usage later on. Right, so that's all in the CipherTrust manager in terms of creating an external key store. You can see it very straightforward. And then now I go back to the KMS console. You can see this CCKM Tokyo key store is being created. Right, so it's a integrated steps. You do not need to do first step to make it appear here. Right, so this is well integrated. So the next step is basically to connect to this key store. Right, so this is basically the step to allow AWS to connect to the CCKM and start to use the external key creation functions as well as the encryption and decryption. Right, so this it says it takes up to 5 minutes, but typically it takes a few seconds. We call less than a minute based on my experience. Let's see how much it takes this time. Yeah, it's connected, right? So it's about 30 seconds. Yeah, it's definitely not 5 minutes. Okay, so now the Snow Key Store is created and connected. We can create a key and then encrypt some data. Have some fun over there. All right, so you can see the status here is also linked and connected. So now I will just create a Snow Keys for this key store. I'll choose the account I created, choose the region, and choose, I mean, you can have all the options. So you can see CCKM provide rich functionality in terms of providing the different type of keys. Creation in the cloud, but today our choice is using external key store, right? So hold your own key feature. And the key source, I choose a CipherTrust, in this case, a link key, which means I do not need to do manual activation later on, right? So the key will automatically appear in the AWS KMS console. So I choose the key store, which is just now I created the key store. Right, I can choose to create a new key or copy existing keys from CipherTrust manager. In this case, I've just create a new key. Say this is DRCM Tokyo Core on key one. Right, so the alias in the AWS, I would choose simple as that, and then create a key. And you can, of course, decide the permissions and policies for this key, for this purpose, demo purpose. I'll just provide some user access. And I will skip the rotation schedule for now. All right, so that's all you need to create an external key once you have the external key store. This is summary information. Let's add it. So within a second, you can see the key being created. Right, so once the key being created, actually you can start to utilize this key in AWS. What they call services. It actually support most of the AWS services, all right, compared to the DKE usage only support the Office 365. I would say AWS external key management actually support most of the AWS service. It's kind of giving customer a wider choice of uploading their sensitive workload and ensure the key sovereignty and control. Right, so then basically here, I can search based on my key ID. It's not AWS managed keys, I searched the wrong place. Yeah, so you can see my key appear here, right? And then you can start to utilize the functions. In this demo purpose, I've just used the S3. Let's use S3 quickly, create a bucket and then encrypt some data and have some fun. Right, so I'll create a new bucket in this purpose, just which is located in the APAC. So, which is in Tokyo. And I'll skip other stuff itself and then focusing on our right, it's focusing on the encryption key choice, then choose the external keys from the option. Right, so then basically I'll by default enable this key and then create a bucket. Right, so once the bucket is created, then I can go to my bucket, APAC, see other stuff I created early on, and then upload a file. Okay, so let's upload this PDF. Let's upload another file. So let's upload another maybe text file. My text files. Right, so just put another file, upload. Right, so once you upload, actually the AWS is still starting to calling the CipherTrust manager to encrypt and decrypt this data, and then we can actually go to the CipherTrust manager console, check the server record. Actually, you can see the use getting CCM key and use CCM key, what we call record, where AWS is actually calling CipherTrust Manager to encrypt the data when you do perform such actions. So once you have that, basically with CipherTrust Manager, you have strong key management control. So what you can do is actually for this hold your own key, I can say, block the key access. Right, so if I block the key access, then I will go back to go back to the S3. Trying to go back to this Tokyo secret. Where is it? Tokyo secret, come on. And I could try to go to the file, say download. Right, so you can see immediately the key access, the file access has been rejected, and then there's an invalid state because the key is actually in your customer's hands control. And I block the key, right? So to prove it, that access itself, you can see the access immediate warning on CipherTrust Manager. This decryption option, transaction has been denied, and and then basically, customer has immediate control on immediate and full ownership in terms of the key access with HYOK key. Right, so the key no longer cache in the AWS itself. Right, so with that, basically, I kind of conclude my demo. I will basically enable the key, unblock the key per se. Yeah, success. And then I can open new tab, S3, go to the same bucket, APAC, Tokyo Secret, so download. Yeah, this is my secret, not very secret at all, but that's my sample file. Thanks, that's all I want to run through. I hope that give you a better explanation of how the AWS external key store works.